بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا يا رب العالمين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala The Lord of the Alameen And salutations upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam His family, his companions and all those who follow his way Until the day of judgment And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst them Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen Amma ba'd inshaAllah And respected brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah, after we have laid the foundation in book one, this evening, inshallah, we start, which I hope many of our students have their books with them, inshallah, or those who have not. PDF is on the computer for download. So we are going to start a book insha'Allah ta'ala. It is called Durus al-Lughat al-Arabiyya. An Arabic language course. And it is for English speaking students. And this book has been taught at the Islamic University of Medina Al-Munawwara. And as we know, the author of the book is Dr. Fa Abdul Rahim. So inshallah ta'ala, our tartib is going to be that we are going to read the lesson. In the beginning, we can see they give us nice, clear pictures. And this is going to assist us, inshallah ta'ala. Thereafter, the harakat, the fatha, kasra, dhamma, tanween, and these things will slowly be removed because you need to familiarize yourself and acquaint yourself to read without the harakat. So inshallah ta'ala, we start off with Ad-Darsul Awwalu. Ad-Darsul Awwalu. Hatha. So there, just as a correction, if we see there, they've written in the book, I don't know if your book has the same. Has your book got that on the ha?
Yes.
Right? So if you're going to read that, it's going to be hadha. No. It's supposed to actually be with the dagged alif hadha. So we have done hadha and we should all know what is the meaning of hadha. So hadha first and foremostly it is In the Arabic language, it is known as the Ismul Ishara, or in the English language, a demonstrative pronoun. So in English, it is known as the demonstrative pronoun, as in Arabic, ismul ishara. Ishara means to point out something. So, hadha, as we've learnt previously, it is used to refer to things, objects which are in close proximity, which is close by, nearby to you. This is hadha, right? And the meaning of hadha, this is. So we start and we read hadha baytun.
Hadha baytun.
Hadha masjidun.
Hadha masjidun.
Hadha babun.
Hadha babun.
Hadha kitabun.
Hadha kitabun.
Hadha qalamun.
Hadha qalamun.
Hadha miftahun.
Hadha miftahun.
Hadha maktabun.
Hadha maktabun.
Hadha sarirun.
Hadha sarirun.
Hadha kursiyun.
Hadha kursiyun.
So in this lesson, we can see, in our first example, hadha baytun. Hadha baytun, which basically we understand it is saying this is a house. This tanween this is now known as the indefinite article. You can't say hadha baytin, hadha baytan. No. It has to say, or it has to make it a clear sentence at the moment. Hadha baytun. It will end with the un sound, as you can see. This is a house. Hadha masjidun. Masjidun. So if anyone says to you, hadha masjidin, you can tell him, brother, sister, sorry. It's supposed to be masjidun. With the tanween, with the dhammatain at the end. So this is a masjid. Hadha babun. This is a door. Hadha kitabun. This is a book. Hadha qalamun. This is a pen. Hadha miftahun. This is a key. Hadha maktabun. This is a desk. Hadha sarirun. This is a bed. Hadha kursiyun. This is a chair. So those are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 new words. 9 new words that you must know at the end of the day. If I ask you, ma hadha, ma hadha, hadha qalamun. If I should ask you, ma hadha, ma hadha, maktabun, where's not the kitab? Maktabun, desk. ما هذا؟ ما هذا؟ Like this. Draw a house. هذا ما هذا؟ هذا. نعم. سرير. Draw bed. سرير. So these are your new words that as we go along, you must know these words. Because later on in the lessons, the same words are going to be used or we're going to be introduced with some new words. So any questions? You have any questions on this lesson? Had. Has everyone understood the lesson? Then we continue, inshallah. So don't, next week when I ask you, pen, desk, kursi, chair, everything, then everyone's going to look, what is happening? What is Sheikh asking us? Talking a different language. Let's turn. Inshallah. Ma hadha. All together, ma hadha, ma hadha. All together, hadha baytun. So in the first, we are asking, what is this? That ma, there is an interrogative particle. An interrogative particle is like you interrogate, you want to ask, you want to spell something which is unknown. Ma ha da. That ma there. And the ma is used again to ask about things or objects. So ma ha da. So they show you a picture there. Hada baytun. Now, if I need to ask what or is this a house, the way I will use it, I will use what we call the Hamzatul Istifham. Ahada baytun. Aha, that ah. This here. Bimana is. Aha, the baytun. Is this a house? So someone asks you, ma hadha? You said, هذا بيت أهذا بيت نعم هذا بيت نعم yes that is affirmative نعم in Arabic yes هذا بيت this is a house next ما هذا هذا قميص قميص as we can see in the picture a shirt قميص أهذا سرير you look at that picture you see the chair لا هذا كرسي So when we see the Hamzatul Istifham being used. Automatically it is asked a question. You've got to respond in one of two ways. Either na'am or la. You cannot respond in any other way. If I ask you, is this so and so? You can't tell me, this is so and so. You've got to tell me, yes, it is so and so. Or, no, it is not. So there, ahadha sarirun, is this a bed? La, hadha kursiyun. No, this is a chair. Ahadha miftahun. La, hadha qalamun. Ma hadha, hadha najmun. So two new words there. Qamisun, najmun, na'am, and la. Right, sisters, there's an exercise. Let's start on page 3 next. Allah ukhti. Tamreen number 1. You read there and you answer. As you start with a maktab, okay, fine. Next, sister.
Ma haza, haza sarirun.
Naam.
Ma haza, haza kitabun.
Naam. Next.
Ma haza, haza baytun.
Naam.
Ma haza, haza babun.
Naam. Sister. First, again, sister, ma hadha. Right, so now you must respond. Naam hadha baytun. Next. Qamisun. Next.
Ahada miftahun.
Miftahun, sister.
Miftahun. La, hada qalamun.
Naam. Allah.
Ahada najmun. Naam. Hada najmun.
Continue the same exercise, brother. From the top again. Restart. You do have practice, inshallah. نعم يلا
ما هذا سرير
نعم
ما هذا هذا كتاب
نعم
ما هذا هذا باب
هذا باب نعم
Haza baytun.
Baytun? Ewa.
Haza. Mana? Ini. Mana? Argaudnya. Haza baytun. Naam. Naam. Haza baytun.
الله بعد
أهذا قميص نعم هذا قميص
أهذا مفتاح لا هذا قلم
نعم
أهذا مفتاح
Mahada Hada Na Najmun.
Najmun, Naam, Ismail. Yes.
Mahada Hada Maktabun.
Mahada Hada Kursiun.
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 Ewa Naam.
ما هذا؟ هذا كتاب. إن
شاء الله. Clear إن شاء الله. Let's go to the next. Have you got, next? Yes. سرير. مش كرسي. سرير. هذا.
Let's go to the same. Just check out something إن شاء الله.
My pitch wrong.
That's right. That's one thing.
Right, go to read and write. Iqra. Waktub. Iqra in Arabic. This is another word you must learn. Iqra. We all know that word. Read. Waktub and write. Now, if you look at the following examples, the word there, tamreen. Tamreen means exercise. Tamreen. As you can see, now they've removed the baris, the harakat, they've removed it. Now we want to see how you read. Sister, yalla, iqra. Again? Right, what does that mean? What is maktab? Yes, yalla. Next, sister.
Sorry, below it or next?
Any or just. Is it on the side?
No, it's the line.
Okay.
Haza sarirun. This is a bed.
Naam, yalla.
Haza baytun. Is this a house?
Sah. Next.
Hada masjidun. This is a mosque.
Naam.
Ma hada. What is this?
And what do they ask? Is it nothing? Khalas. Next. Is that?
Ma hada masjidun.
You see, they ask the question there. When they asked the question, they ahada baytun. The answer was to read la hada masjid. Sisters, take note how the book is flowing. So when they ask, they ma hada hada kursiyun, ahada baytun, la hada masjidun, and then the last ma hada hada miftahun. Right, sister? Right to left. Hada qalamun. Naam. Next. Hada kursiyun. Sister's reading.
Hada
miftahun. Naam. Same. First.
Hada maktabun.
Good.
This is a desk.
Khalas. Next.
Hada sarirun.
This is a
bed.
Brothers, follow Left, you're not right. Following what the book is instructing.
Left to right or right to bottom?
Left to right.
Right to left.
From right to left.
هذا مكتب هذا مسجد هذا قلم هذا سرير ما هذا هذا كرسي أهذا بيت لا هذا مسجد ما هذا هذا مفتاح. This is the way we must be reading it. يلا Remember, we're not doing English. Arabic is different. Ya Allah. Naam. Next.
Hada sarirun, this is a bed.
Ma hada.
So now the brother will answer that.
Hada kursiyun.
Naam. تفضل يا اخي.
نعم. لا هذا مسجد.
نعم. حجي بركات.
هذا
سلولي سلولي.
ما هذا؟
يس.
هذا
تمام. هذا اسماعيل.
هذا مكتب.
نيكست براذر تفضل.
هذا مسجد.
هذا كلام.
Tamam. So now we've learned how to put the harakat on insha'Allah. Let's continue with how to ask Man hadha? Man. So ma is used for objects, things. As for man, we use it with people. Man. Man hadha. All together.
Man hadha.
Hadha tabibun.
Hadha tabibun.
Again. Man hadha.
Man hadha.
هذا طبيب.
هذا طبيب.
Next line. من هذا؟
من هذا؟
هذا ولد.
هذا ولد.
Right? As we can see in the picture, طبيب is a doctor. And ولد is a boy. نعم. We continue. من هذا؟
من هذا؟
هذا طالب.
هذا طالب.
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 طالب is a student. نعم. تلميذ is also a student. Same. تلميذ is also a student. أهذا ولد؟
أهذا ولد؟
لا هذا رجل.
هذا رجل.
So that question there, is this a boy? No. لا هذا رجل. This is a man. Again, all together. From the start. من هذا؟
من هذا؟
هذا طبيب.
هذا طبيب.
من هذا؟
من هذا؟
هذا ولد.
هذا ولد.
من هذا؟
من هذا؟
هذا طالب.
هذا طالب.
أهذا ولد؟
أهذا ولد؟
لا.
لا.
هذا رجل.
هذا رجل.
Right. Close the books. I'm going to give you the English words now. And we'll go down the line and we ask to give the Arabic. Let's see, inshallah.
Just the words that we just
looked
at as well?
Just the words we've done.
In the book?
In the book. Don't worry.
La. La. Haza.
Buku.
Kitab.
Naam.
No, buku.
Stretching.
Kangaroo.
Thank you.
Me?
Yes.
Haza wa waladun.
Yes. Answer.
La haza talibun.
تفضل يا اخي. Is this a shirt?
هذا قميص.
لا
هذا
لا not a just لا
لا هذا مفتاحول.
Haji Sam, jadi wan insya Allah. No no no, easy one Haji Sam. What is this? What? Okay? No no, what? When I ask a question, remember? I'm asking. Ma hada. Ma hada is what is this?
هذا مسجد لا هذا بيت
بيت الله أنشف الله الحمد لله وإن شاء الله let's just finish off page. So then they give us on the next page. Ma hada. All together.
Ma hada.
Hada masjidun.
Hada masjidun.
Man hada.
Man hada.
Ah. First. All right, church. Back to front. First. Man hada.
Man hada.
Hada tajirun. Tajir is a trader or a business person. From tijara, tajir. So there's a new word, tajirun. This is a trader or a businessman. In the next one, ma hada.
Ma hada.
Hada masjidun.
Hada masjidun.
You know that one? Next, hada kalbun.
Hada kalbun.
Kalbun, a dog. As you can see in the picture. Kalbun is a dog. Next, ahada kalbun.
Ahada kalbun.
Is this a dog? La. Ahada qittun.
Ahada qittun.
So cat, qittun. Kitun.
Kitun.
And the next one. Hada himarun.
Hada himarun.
This is a
donkey.
Himar. أهذا حمار؟
أهذا حمار؟
Careful brothers. أهذا is this. أهذا be careful. If you miss out that Hamza, you're going to misunderstand that a question is being asked here. أهذا حمار؟
أهذا حمار؟
لا. هذا حصان. So we have our animals, kalbun, qittun, himar, and hisanun. تاجرٌ كلبٌ قطٌ حمارٌ حصانٌ So حمار a donkey حصان a horse قط a cat كلب a dog and then we have the trader and then we have
Jamal
وما هذا
وما هذا
و in Arabic
end
meaning end so it is وما هذا and what is this هذا جمل
هذا جمل
جمل Camel. ما هذا؟
ما هذا؟
هذا ديكون.
هذا ديكون.
That is a rooster. What I would advise the brothers and sisters, you know what you do with these words? All your new words, write them out 3 times in a book. So that's the only way you're going to remember them. Write them out 3 times, like, for example, all our words that we did. Those that you know, no problem. Those that you don't know, like the new ones, Dikun, Tajunun, Kalbun, Qittun, Himarun, Hisanun, Jamalun, write them out 3 times so you will, inshallah, remember them. من هذا؟
من هذا؟
هذا مدرس.
هذا مدرس.
Right. Some of you must take note of this word because lesson is thus, and the person that teaches the lesson is called a مدرس. So. Dars we did. Darsul awwal, first lesson. Darsun. A lesson. Now we have. Careful there, not mudarra. You see here the shatta. This means this is actually at the bottom here. Ri. Mudarrisun.
So it's a teacher.
A teacher. And And the last one there is Ahada Kamisun. And the Kamis?
No, okay.
What is your one?
Finish that.
Is that end?
Sure.
Naam.
No.
Okay, just an exercise. Okay, khair. Exercise tamreen. Iqra waktub. Read and write. Ma hadha? Hadha qalamun.
Hadha qalamun.
Hadha kalbun.
Hadha kalbun.
Man hadha?
Man hadha?
Hadha tabibun.
Hadha tabibun.
Hadha jamalun.
Hadha jamalun.
Ahadha diikun.
Ahadha diikun.
Naam.
Naam.
Ahadha kalbun.
Ahadha kalbun.
La.
La.
Hadha qittun.
Hadha qittun.
Ahadha hisanun.
Ahadha hisanun.
La.
La.
Hadha himarun.
Hadha himarun.
أهذا ولد؟
أهذا ولد؟
نعم.
نعم.
هذا؟
هذا
ولد.
ولد.
خلاص بدي. من هذا؟
من هذا؟
هذا رجل.
هذا رجل.
Let's look at the next page. Points to remember. In this lesson, we learn the following patterns. So there, made easier for you sisters and brothers. Ma hadha, what is this? Hadha kitabun, this is a book. Ahadha baytun, is this a house? Naam, hadha baytun. La, hadha masjidun. Man hadha, who is this? So there's notes at the bottom. Number one, hadha, pronounced hadha, but it's written without the first alif. Arabic has no word corresponding to the English is, i.e. Arabic has no copula. Number three, there is no word in Arabic corresponding to a in English, as in this is a book. The n sound at the end of the Arabic noun, for example, the kitabun, or baytun, or masjidun, is the Arabic indefinite article corresponding to the English a or and. This n sound is called tanween. And number four, the particle hamza there, placed at the beginning of a statement, turns it into a question. Example, hadha baytun, this is a house. Ahadha baytun, is this a house? And then there's your vocab. There's all the vocab for you, inshallah. Starting with, you can look at maybe baytun. Masjidun,
babun,
kitabun, qalamun, miftahun, maktabun, sarirun, kursiyun, najmun, qamisun, tabibun, waladun, طالب رجل تاجر كلب قط حمار حصان جمل ديك مدرس and there's the last one منديل
منديل.
Mandil is a handkerchief. Or tissue. So when I say ahada mandilun, is this a tissue? La hada qamisun. As an example. Min di lun. Okay? Inshallah, we stop there. Next week, we will continue with Adam Sufan. Yes, sister?
When you gave us the words last time, you gave us a different word for student and teacher. Does it matter which one we use?
You can add that one to me that I gave you?
Yeah.
To me, right?
Yeah.
I was Ustad.
Muallimun.
Yes. You can add those words if you want to onto it.
But like when you put it into context, does it make a difference?
No. Same. You refer to a tilmid, we'll also refer to a student, a talib. Comes from the talaba, which is to search. So student searches for search of knowledge. And muallim comes from the word ilm. Ilm is also knowledge. Muallim, the one who has knowledge, who is basically also considered as a teacher.
We address ma'af for objects.
Objects.
Man is for people.
People.
Then the answer of ahaza can be used for both. The way it is, we
yes.
use for both.
Yes.
Ahaza
can be used for both. But addressing people, man, and for addressing objects, animals, ma. But when you respond, ahada, tabibun, ahada, jamalun, ahada, kalbun, straight, same. No difference, inshallah. Okay? So, inshallah, next week, we'll start with ad-dars al-thani, which we will deal with. Very, very short lesson, basically, ad-dars al-thani, with dhalika, which is just asking for things at a distance, inshallah. And so, we'll go through, inshallah, ta'ala. So very, very importantly for you as students, inshallah, is to learn your new words. Once you've got the vocab, inshallah, as we go through the lessons, you will see how easy to become, inshallah, ta'ala. Sure. Exactly. Inshallah.